Hey subscribers and watchers, what's up? It's me, Vivs here from SlyNerd. In this video, it's time to talk about the one thing I didn't talk for so long, how to convert from pixels to DPs and vice versa. But before I do that, two things that I want to show you. One, if you go to Google and if you type SlyNerd Udemy, you will find our series where we are going to talk about practical stuff on how to make apps for Android, iOS and so on. Two, if you go to our channel, SlyNerd, if you go to playlist, you will find this video and the rest of the videos right here inside the playlist called Android Videos. So now let's get back. Everyone keeps hearing these words, DPs and pixels. So what's the problem here? This is the problem. You see, on the left side, you have 1 inch of space and less number of pixels are fitting in. In the middle, there's like more of them, and on the right hand side, maximum amount of pixels fitting out there. So this is the issue. When you say an image is 40 by 40 pixels, you are really doing a big mistake, because on this left side screen here, that 40 by 40 is going to look different compared to what it does on the right and the middle. So let's take a look at this in a little more detail. So there are some units here on the left hand side, and there is 1 inch of space here in the third column. And the only question that you care about right now is, does it look the same on every physical screen out there? And that is the problem. You see, pixels, they don't. Look, there's a no written over there. And if you talk about inches, they look same. Yes, millimeters, points on these values are physical units. You know, 1 millimeter is going to remain the same everywhere in the world, regardless of what you do with it. So we don't really care about inches, millimeters or points. Rather, we care about pixels, density independent pixels and scale pixels. Now, if you remember, scale pixels are used for fonts, whereas density independent pixels are used for everything else. That would be images, size of your widgets, views, layouts, everything is controlled in terms of DPs. So given that, here is the idea. The number of pixels per inch may actually vary, but the number of DPs, they could be in fixed numbers like 160 or 240 or 320. It depends on the device on which you're currently running your app. So let's take a further detail at what categories exist out there. At the lowest end, you have 120 per inch, and at the highest end, you have 640 per inch. And your device doesn't exactly have 120 or 160. Rather, it could have something like 139.5, and your Android system will say that it is 160. So you gotta make sure, or you gotta remember, that these things are approximated on your device. And we will see this when we run our demo app that converts between pixels and DPs. So let's take a look at what 40 by 40 looks like. There you go. It looks the same. And it looks to take the same size on the screen when you run it on both devices. One of them has 160 pixels per inch, the other is 240, which is obviously higher density, but 40 by 40 DP is gonna look the same. But if you use 40 by 40 pixels, then there's gonna be less pixels here on the 241 compared to the 161. I mean, it's gonna look smaller. So let's go to Android Studio and find out how we can convert between pixels and density independent pixels and see how that conversion math makes sense. So meet display metrics, the class that contains all sorts of information like what is the width and height of the screen in pixels, what is the density of your device along the x-axis, along the y-axis, and the scale density, that is the SP, and your density DPI and logical density. Now all these things, if you're not sure what these values contain, you can simply print them on the screen with your Logcat or Toast and you can check out what they contain. But here in my case, I'll go to Android Studio and I have this class here called util, which has this single method that says log display metrics. Now the way I get the display metrics object is not by constructing it, rather I need a context. From the context, I get resources, and from the resources, I get display metrics. Now I can just print it out by calling toString on it. The only thing, it doesn't print out the density DPI, which is why I have separately added this string at the end that prints the density DPI out there. So let's go and use this inside a fragment or an activity and take a look at what happens. So I have a fragment here called fragment DP to PX. It's basically a simple calculator that's going to display stuff on the screen. So if you take a look at the onViewCreated method here, I have my toast message that says make text get activity util.log display metrics, and here it's gonna simply call this method, and when we run the app, let's find out what happens. So there's my app running. If I go to the menu here in the main activity and select DPPX converter, that you are. There's a display matrix that prints everything out, the density, the width, as you just saw. It's a lot of details out there. I should have put it in the log cat, but basically our device density is 320. Now what this simply means is there are 320 dots per inch. Now if there are 160 dots per inch, then 1 pixel and 1 dB are same. If there are 320, then it's quite obvious that there are double the number of pixels for each dB, right? So let's do this calculation back in the util class. Let's have the methods responsible for doing that. That would be convert dB to pixel and convert pixels to dB. Let's take a look first at how we can convert dB to pixel. So the idea is very simple. Take the amount of dB, say 10 dB, measure the density of your device, which would be 240 or 320 or some value of that sort. Divide that by 160. So in simple words, if the density of the device is 160, then dPs or pixels are gonna be same. So let's code this. So there you go, I use the property displayMatrix.densityDPI and divide that by 160 to get the proper value in pixels and simply return that value. The same way I can get the value from pixels to dPs as well. The idea here is simple. In this equation which you have above, where you said pixels is blah blah blah, just take everything else on the left hand side and you are left with dPs. That would simply mean pixels divided by the density of the device, which in turn is divided by 160 internally. So in other words, if the density of the device is 160, then pixels and dPs are gonna turn out to be the same. So let's again complete the math behind it. So there you are, take the amount of pixels, divide it with 160 and get the equation returned. Now let's test this out and see if it works properly or not. So this would be my app running. This is my main activity. It looks blank, but it isn't. There is a menu at the top left where I have the option to add several fragments through fragment transactions. The code for this is available on GitHub. If you go to Google and type SlideNote GitHub. So here, if you take a look at the second option that says DP PX converter, let's choose that. When I do this, the fragment transaction is going to add a fragment, and you notice this display matrix over here that displays all the properties of your current screen. Now I have this area at the top where it says your density is 320. This is a text view. Then you notice that there is this edit text that is going to ask your input and a spinner that gives you two choices. In other words, you can either choose to convert the value to dPs or you can convert it to pixels. For example, if you enter an input, say 24, that becomes 48.0 pixels because in our case, it's a 320 ppi or dpi device where 2 pixels are gonna make 1 dp. So if I select the other option, which would be dps here, you can immediately notice it becomes 12.0. In other words, 24 pixels becomes 12 dps. And if I select pixels, 24 becomes 48. So how did I do this? Let's go to our fragment dp to px and take a look at what's going on. I did not use a button saying convert. I rather use the text watcher that's going to monitor the input actively. Whenever the text is changed, it's gonna simply get that input if that input is not null or empty, and it's going to call this method updateUI, where it's gonna pass the input and it's gonna pass the currently selected position in the spinner. At the same time, the spinner also has an onItemSelected listener where every time the item changes, once again, it's gonna call the updateUI method and it's gonna get the input from the edit text and convert that to a string and give the position that was changed. Now, this updateUI method is pretty simple. It's gonna take the input, check if it's not null, not empty, and it's gonna have this try catch statement. We're gonna try to convert the input to a number. Now, notice that if you go back to the app and if you try to enter, say, ABC, it immediately says invalid input here. In other words, we don't want your app to crash trying to convert an alphanumeric digit into something else, right? So that's why I have this number format exception where I have set invalid input right here. So I take the input, convert that by float.parseFloat, and I check if the position is zero. If that's the case, I use the util.convert dp to pixels. Otherwise, I use the util.convert pixels to dps that you see here. That's all. So hopefully you liked my simple example of px to dp and vice versa. In the meantime, if you like what you saw, go ahead, type SlideNote Udemy on Google and check out our practical courses that are coming up. And there's SlideNote Twitter and SlideNote Facebook as far as social is concerned. And all the code is out there if you type SlideNote GitHub on Google. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.